जम्मू लिंक्स न्यूज टॉप स्टोरीज इज ब्रॉट टू यू बाय तस्या हर्बल्स अल्कोहल बेस्ड हैंड सैनिटाइजर विद नीम एंड एलोवेरा एक्सट्रैक्ट्स हेल्पिंग इंडिया फाइट कोविड-19. A day after his death, swab samples of a 70-year-old man from South Kashmir's Shopian district tested positive for the novel coronavirus, taking the death count due to COVID-19 in Jammu and Kashmir to 28. So far, Srinagar district has seen highest number of fatalities, 7 followed by Anantnag and Baramulla with 5 deaths each. Kulgam has reported 4 while Budgam and Jammu have 2 each, and 1 death each has been reported from Bandipora, Shopian and Udhampur. In a major breakthrough in Pulwama-like bombing case, police has identified the owner of the explosives-laden car which belonged to Hidayatullah Malik, an active member of Hizbul Mujahideen terror group. According to the police, Hidayatullah Malik is a resident of Sharadpura in Shopian who joined the terrorist ranks in July 2019. The security forces in J&K averted a major incident of a 2019 Pulwama-like vehicle-borne attack on Thursday morning when they chased and seized a car laden with 40 to 45 kg of explosives in the district. Top government sources on Friday virtually contradicted US President Donald Trump's claim of a conversation between him and Prime Minister Narendra Modi on India's ongoing military standoff with China in eastern Ladakh. There has been no recent contact between Prime Minister Modi and President Trump, the sources said. The clarification came hours after Trump said in Washington that he had spoken to Modi and that the Indian Prime Minister is not in a good mood over the big conflict between India and China. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi on Friday asked the government to come clean on the border standoff with China and tell the country what exactly is happening, as its silence is fueling speculation and uncertainty. The standoff started in the Ladakh region, and after China took an aggressive stand and deployed around 6,000 troops of the People's Liberation Army. A fire engulfed the forest stretch in Forward Balakot area on Friday along the line of control in Poonch district and triggered explosion of landmines. The fire started across the border and spread on this side. Many acres of forest area along the LOC came under fire, which damaged the green gold and also triggered some explosions of anti-personal landmines that stand installed as a part of anti-infiltration grid. The wife of Jammu and Kashmir Congress leader Saifuddin Sos has moved to the Supreme Court, challenging his house arrest since August 5, 2019. The plea filed by Mumtazunisa Sos, spouse of the Congress leader, said that despite the arrest having been made 10 months ago, she has not been told about the reason for the move. Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Home Minister Amit Shah met on Friday to deliberate over the way out of lockdown as its fourth phase draws to a close this week. The meeting comes a day after the Home Minister spoke to chief ministers to discuss their views on extending the lockdown and future strategy to fight the pandemic. Officials said that the CMs in meeting with Shah contended that the lockdown should be extended with considerable relaxation in economic activity. In his first remarks after being named as a member of Delimitation Commission National Conference Member of Parliament, Hasnain Masoodi on Friday said that he can't be part of anything which he opposed in the Supreme Court. Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla had on Thursday nominated 3 NCMPs, Dr. Farooq Abdullah, Justice Hasnain Masoodi and Mohammad Akbar Lone, as associate members of Delimitation Commission set up by the Government of India for fixing boundaries of assembly segments in Jammu and Kashmir. India's coronavirus death toll has surpassed that of China after it reported a total of 4,706 fatalities, while it overtook Turkey to become the 9th worst hit nation by the pandemic with 1,65,799 COVID-19 cases. The country has registered 175 deaths and a record 7,466 fresh coronavirus infection cases in the last 24 hours till Friday 8 a.m., according to the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. India has now overtaken Turkey and is the 9th most affected nation in terms of COVID-19 cases after the US, Brazil, Russia, UK, Spain, Italy, France and Germany. The explosives-laden vehicle which was spotted and defused in Pulwama on Thursday was owned by an active Hizbul Mujahideen terrorist. A police official said the car belonged to Hidayatullah Malik, an active Hizb militant from Shopian, Sharadpura. Police sources said Malik had joined the terrorist ranks in July last year. Yashpal Kundal, former minister, called on the Lieutenant Governor Girish Chandra Murmu. Kundal submitted a memorandum of demands regarding several issues of public importance, including reservation in promotion to the government employees belonging to SC and ST categories. The Lieutenant Governor, while interacting with the former minister, observed that the government is committed towards the welfare of every section of the society. Advisor to Lieutenant Governor Farooq Khan today took stock of the arrangements for registration and screening of inbound and outbound passengers at Jammu Airport, which has recently resumed operations after relaxation in COVID-19 lockdown norms. Advisor Khan, while interacting with the screening and facilitation teams from different departments, inquired about different processes, vis-a-vis testing of passengers and their subsequent quarantine.